Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel and this video. So today we're going to see a very famous businessman's life, that is J.R.D. Tata. J.R.D. Tata was an Indian industrialist, entrepreneur and a chairman of Tata Group, a very well-known group, a very well-known company, not only in India but also like worldwide. So J.R.D. Tata, who was born on 29 July 1994 in Paris, France, and he died on 29 November 1993 in Geneva, Switzerland. So J.R.D. Tata, he is a very known industrialist and very great personality. So he has done many industries, like in under the Tata Group, he has built many industries and many like businesses. For example, Tata Motors, Tata Steels, Tata Chemicals, Tata Consumer Products, the company Titan, Tata Capital, Tata Power, Tata Advanced System, and many Indian hotels. Not only that, he has also opened Tata Communication. And within this, some of the very famous groups are group of companies he have opened is like Tata Motors, Titan Industry, Tata Salt, Voltas, and Air India. He is the first licensed pilot of India also. His early life. He was born into a Tata family of India. He was a son of a noted businessman Ratanji Tata and his wife Suzanne. His mother Suzanne was the first woman in India to drive a car. Now J.R.D. Tata was born as Jahangir on 29 July 1994 in Paris. Family, Parisi family in Paris, France. He was second child of the businessman Ratanji Tata and his French wife. His father was the first cousin of Jamsetji Tata. He was an industrialist in India. He had one elder sister Saila, a younger sister Radhebe, and two younger brother Dharab and Jamshed. Jamshed usually called Jimmy Tata. His early life also continues like his mother was a French so he spent his most of the time in France, and as a result he is like very much fluent in French, and French is considered to be his first language. He attended the Janson de Sailly school in Paris. Tata was educated in London, Japan and France. When his father joined the Tata company, he moved the whole family to London. During this time, J.R.D.'s mother died at the age of 43, while his father was in India and his family was in France. After his mother's death, Ratanji Tata, his father, decided to move his family to India and sent J.R.D. Tata to England for higher studies in October 1923. He was enrolled in a grammar school. So as a citizen of France, J.R.D. Tata had enlisted in the army for at least a year. And in between of grammar school and his time in army, he spent brief spell at home in Bombay. After joining the French army, he posted into a regiment of spies. So, after his time in French army, his father, Ratanji Tata, decided him to bring back to India and join the Tata company. So, in 1929, Tata re-announced his French citizenship and became an Indian citizen. From 1904 to 1929, he was a French citizen, but then from 1929 to till his death 1993, he was an Indian citizen because he just transferred from French to India. J.R.D. Tata's father, his Ratanji Tata, Suzanne Tata, his mother, and some of his family photos. These are his siblings. The first photo is with all the siblings and J.R.D. Tata, of course. And this is J.R. Tata with his sister, with his sister Saila, and this is his childhood photo. His wife and children. So his wife is Thelema Vikaji Tata. He and his wife Thelema, who he married after a Paris romance in 1930, did not have any children, though J.R. Tata always appeared with most comfortable with kids. Now his career. He was a founder of various institutes, including Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Tata Memorial Hospital, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Tata Motors, TCS, National Institute of Advanced Studies, and National Center of Performing Arts. On 10th of February 1929, Tata obtained the first pilot license issued in India. He was the first pilot. He later became known as the father of Indian civil aviation. He founded India's first commercial airline, Tata Airlines, in 1932, which became Air India in 1946, now India's national air airline. He joined Tata Sons as an unpaid apprentice in 1925. In 1938, at the age of 34, he became or elected as a chairman of Tata Sons, making him the head of the largest industrial group in India. He took over as a chairman of Tata Sons from his second cousin, Norvaji. And for decades, he directed a huge Tata group of companies with major interest in steel, engineering, power, chemicals, and hospitality. He was famous for succeeding in business while maintaining high ethical standards and refusing to bribe politicians or use a black market. He also founded Tata Institute of Social Science, TISS, 1936, the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, TIFR, 1945, and National Center of Performing Arts. He was a trustee of Sir Dorabji Tata Trust from his inception in 1932 for over half a century. Under his guidance, this trust established Asia's first cancer hospital, the Tata Memorial Center for Cancer Research and Treatment in Bombay, 1941. In 1945, he founded Tata Motors. In 1948, Tata launched Air India International as India's first international airline. In 1953, the Indian government appointed Tata as the chairman of Air India and a director on the board of Indian Airlines, as a position he retained for 25 years. In 1945, he founded Tata Motors and launched these all airlines. He also founded founding member of the first governing body of NCAER. The National Council appealed economic research in New Delhi. India's first independent economy policy institute established in 1956. In 1968, he founded Tata Consultancy Services and Tata Computer Center in 1979. In 1987, he founded Titan Industries. Jamshedpur was also selected as a UN Global Compact City because of the quality life condition of sanitation, roads, and welfare that were offered by Tata Steel. J.R. Tata received many awards and honors. Tata received a number of awards. He conferred the honorary rank of group captain by the Indian Air Force in 1948. He was promoted to the Air Commodore rank, like in the army, on 4th October 1966. And he is further promoted on 1st April 1974 of Air Vice Marshal rank. Several international awards for aviation were given to him. The Tony Jannus Award in March 1979, the Golden Air Medal for Federation and many things international in 1985, the Edward Warner Award of International Civil Aviation Organization, Canada in 1986, and many medals also which he received in 1988. He received a Padma Bhushan in 1955. The French Legion Award honor was best awarded on him in 1983. In 1992, because of his selflessness and humanitarian and his behavior, Tata was awarded India's highest civilian honor, the Bharat Ratna, in the same year by the time of P.V. Narasimha Rao. In 2012, Tata was ranked the 6th greatest Indian in the Outlook magazine poll, conducted in the conjunction with CNN, IBN, and the History of 18 channel with BBC. And Tata was best awarded with the United Nations Population Award for like many of his deeds and successful implementation, family planning, movement in India, and many official and government policies. His memory, the government of Maharashtra named his its first double-decker bridge, the Bharat Ratna J.R.D. Tata Overbridge at Nasik Phata, Pimpri, Chikanwada. His death and legacy. Tata died in Genoa, Switzerland, on 29 November 1993 at the age of 89 of a kidney infection. He said few days before his passing, like, how gentle is to die, he said it in French. Upon his death, the Indian Parliament adjourned his memory, an honor not to usually given to a person who are not member of the Parliament. He was buried at the Père Lachaise Cemetery in Paris. This was the beautiful life of J.R.D. Tata. He was a great personality with a very successful businessman. So thanks for watching. I really hope you liked the video. Bye.